So welcome back. This is our last topic in chapter 2. The name of our chapter is Sports and Nutrition. So in this chapter, the last topic is 3.3, eating for weight control. In this topic, there is a healthy weight, the pitfall of dieting, food intolerance, and the last one is food myths. So the first one is a healthy weight. What do you mean by healthy weight? What is the concept of the healthy weight? So in simple words, we can say that a healthy weight is the weight that at which an individual eats a healthy life without any risk of diseases. It means that if a person at healthy weight, he can lead a healthy life. In other hand, we can say that if a person or individual is not a healthy weight, he faces a lot of problems, he faces a lot of diseases. So in unhealthy weight, there are various health problems such as heart diseases, stroke, high blood pressure, diabetes. So after healthy weight, so second one is method to control healthy body weight. So the stress should be laid on the following points for proper method to control healthy weight or healthy body weight. The first one is set appropriate goal. Second one, lay stress on health, not on weight. The third one is cut calories. Fourth one is active lifestyle. The fourth one is active lifestyle, bring out sport. The sixth one is yoga exercises. The seventh one is avoid fatty food. And eighth one is avoid junk food and fast food. Ninth one is avoid overeating. The tenth one is do not overeating. And the last one is do not eat frequently. So, method to calculate BMI. So, BMI is useful for to know the, our body weight, our healthy body weight. So, how we know our healthy body weight? So, with the help of BMI, we should know our body weight, means our body weight, either it's be underweight, either it's be normal weight, or either it's be overweight. So here there is some formula to know the BMI. Here BMI represents the body mass index. So BMI is equal to weight upon height into height. Clear? So how to measure? Suppose if my weight is 70 kg and my height is 175, then we should write down the first of all weight. Weight is 70 and the height is 175. So you should multiply it two times. So 175 into 175. Clear? So the World Health Organization, the rate for understanding healthy weight, underweight, and normal weight, or and obesity by the BMI. So there is some categories. If our weight is less than 18.5, so suppose our weight is underweight. If our weight is in between 18.5 to 24.9, so our weight is in normal weight. Same, our weight is 25 to 29.9, so our weight is overweight. So means obesity. Obesity means overweight is too much. Means the person who is obesity, means each person is fatty and faces a lot of problems. We already discussed a problem such as stroke volume problems, heart problems, diabetes, asthmas. The person who is in this category, in obesity 1, 2, 3, class 1, class 2 and class 3, they are facing a lot of problems and a lot of diseases. Clear? So this is BMI. So next topic is pitfall of dieting. What is the pitfall of? The meaning of pitfall is dangerous. The things which are dangerous for our body are the thing dangerous for our dieting. These are the pitfall of the dieting. So in the simple words, we can say that nowadays everybody wants to remain slim and trim, because after all it's maybe it's trend or some people are follow these fashions. So the individual who are overweight also wants to reduce or lose weight. There are various methods of weight loss, most of them to do dieting, to lose their weight. In the beginning, dieting produces a good result or success. We are all aware that, as simple as it sounds, eat less and exercise more to burn calories. We know that scientific fact, but it is difficult to implement. In fact, there are some pitfalls, or you can say that some dangers of dieting that keep us away from losing or reduce weight. The major pitfall of dieting are, so next one is avoid rich carbohydrate food, don't skip meal, avoid alcohol, smoking and drugs, regular exercises or physical activity, balancing the intake of calorie and extreme reduce of calories. Second one is restrictions on some nutrients or nutrition. The third one is skip meals. The fourth one is intake of calories through drinking. And the fifth one is underestimate the calories. And the second last one is intake of labeled food. And the last one is no performing exercises. These are all the pitfall of the dieting. Basis of that, the knowledge we should not believe in food myths. The most common food myths are below. So we should clear the concept of food myths. The first one, I'll give you example some myths. The first one is, do not take milk immediately after eating fish. The second one is, potato make you fat. The third one is, fat free product will help you in losing weight. The third one is, eggs increase cholesterol level, so avoid them. So we should not eat. So there are some myths that we should not eat eggs because it creates a lot of cholesterol in our body and which is bad for our health. So this is also a myth. Then the second last one is drink while eating make you fat. This is also a myth. Even we should not drink while eating. We should avoid drinking when we are eating some food. The last one is exercise make you eat more. So it is not possible that if we do exercise regularly and we eat more. So we eat limited on the basis of exercises. So these are some myths of food.